All right. With the risk of sounding pompous, hey chick, how are you? Cock and what? How are you? Oh, go back to your mommy. Go back to your mommy. I'm a bad guy. Chasing the chicken. Yes. Bye bye. Okay. So with the risk of sounding pompous, I'm going to give you a statement. You know, intelligent people like to be alone. Successful people, really successful, they like to be alone. Creative minds, they like to be alone. I'm not talking of businessmen. I'm talking of people with great amount of intelligence, people with great amount of creativity, and people who have amazing minds. They like to be alone. Now, I know what you're thinking. Oh yeah, Loy, you're alone, so that's why you're a great mind. Oh, very good. Fantastic. No, that's not the case. I'll logically explain to you why did I say this. Okay. Now, it has been 4 or 5 years since I've been in some movie and I like to be alone. And prior to that, yes, I was in a live-in relationship that was married for the purpose of, you know, being in a Muslim country. But even that time, when my partner or wife used to go to work, I was alone the whole day. The only time I would be with someone is either when I was sleeping around with another girl or, you know, my partner came home late. Yeah, I was cheating on my partner. Yeah. Which was before. Now, become a nice guy. Okay. So, why is it? The question is, why is it that I wanted to be alone? Now, here's the funny thing. People who normally like to be alone are people who don't, either don't have social skills, or they are a klutz, or they are pretty dumb with, you know, getting along with people, or in my case, too aggressive. You know, love to seek attention those days. Love to seek attention and love to stand out and love to be boisterous and love to be loved. And, oh, those days I would do just about anything to get noticed. If I would go in a room, I would want to be noticed by everyone. So, now what happens is when you're surrounded by people, you have to give your time to people. You have to give your energy to people. You have to give your attention to people. You have to give your focus. And let's say, for example, you and your friends are going to meet out for Pizza Hut or Burger King or for a movie. Let's assume. First is you have to plan it out. After you plan it out, you all have to get ready, dress up. That takes time. After you dress up, you have to drive down to that venue. Once you drive down to the venue, you have to hang out with your friends, talk, this, that, and fool around and get all the attention and feel special and be loud and obnoxious. Then you buy the popcorn or the food or whatever. Then you go watch a movie. After you watch the movie, then you go out and then you guys plan, okay, let's go eat food, and you spend time over there. And by the time you finish hanging out and all that, you drive back home. And then once you're at home, okay, you change your outfit and then you're back in your world. Now, if you actually look at it, you're exhausted by the end of the day. You have spent the whole day, energy, time, effort, money, attention, everything on friends. Now, just imagine if you had a family and you're inviting your family and other people's families, and you have to keep everything ready. If they are coming to your place, then you have to spend time with them, talk to them, be with them, engage with them. You can't tell them get out. They will stay as long as they like. And then after they're exhausted, okay, fine, we'll go, bye. And after they go, you have to wash their dishes and keep everything in order and prepare for the next day. And same thing if you have to go to someone else's house. I've given you situations where you have friends, you have family. In fact, even if you have your own private family, sometimes even your child takes your time, your child demands your attention. And if you don't have an understanding wife, your whole energy, everything will go on keeping her happy. Take her out, go for a holiday, go watch a movie, go for an outing. There also, same thing. Now in all these areas that I mentioned, first is time. Time gets spent. Second one is your energy, which, you know, depletes as throughout the end of the day. Your concentration, your focus, your effort. Money is the last, but it also gets spent. Now just imagine, instead of having all these friends, if you are alone, you'll spend all the time by yourself. In fact, today, unfortunately, what has happened is, previously at least people used to go out. The children used to go out to play cricket or football or some games. Today they are busy on their smartphone. The attention, the focus, everything is WhatsApp, let me respond. Okay, Facebook, oh, he said this, let me say that. YouTube, he commented, let me show him. Oh, I saw his video, he is a jackass, let me. So now what happens with all this? You're giving your time, your attention. But when you're alone and you're focused on your task at hand, when you close out all the noise, then your mind gets cleared of all that clutter and you think, okay, what do I want to do now? What's the best use of my time right now? What do I really want to focus on? What gives me the best ROI? What's important to me at this time? What should I be thinking about? What should I be solving? You know, in fact, when I do important tasks, even music is not there. Sometimes I even switch off the AC because I don't want to hear the hum. You know, I sometimes put the Sony, that MX or something, soundproof, you know, it removes the sound. It makes you feel as if you're in a vacuum. I put that, I close my eyes. My iMac is on with Google Docs. Or sometimes it's like a piece of paper and pen or pencil. And I sit, I close my eyes. I don't think anything, I just let go. And I'll tell you that that process itself helps me get ideas. Ideas to implement, not just ideas. It helps me think clearly. It helps me focus. It helps me kind of, like this, you know, calibrate. Because if you're constantly bombarded with music, with entertainment, with people chirping in your ears, you reading stuff, you interacting with people, when do you get time for yourself, man? That's why for me, why do you think I chose to be on this island? Why do you think I charge people more money for my time? Because after I get my client, I like to switch off. I like to switch off, I like to recalibrate. Why do you think I've been able to grow my brand to this level? I'm not saying it's a global brand and I'm making millions of dollars like these billionaires and all that. I thought it was a snake. This one was a, you know, like a climber. No? Looked like a snake. That was close. Just imagine a green snake. Okay, anyway. Excitement. See, look, I'm not trying to say because you're surrounded with friends and family and because I'm alone, I'm better than you. No, I'm telling you facts. Just for a minute, look at your mother and father. I'm sure they are good people. Their heart is good. They are nice people. But can they contribute anything to your intellectual growth? If they can, and they are better than you and smarter than you and great, instead of being sitting with your mother and father and listening to blah blah blah, they are listening. Your relatives, quack quack quack, they talk. Your friends who are your age who talk nothing but fucking bullshit. Okay, interacting with other people, the noise and the losers of the everyday world who are passing by and showing off and all that. You sit quietly. Sit quiet in your room. Sit quietly and focus. Ask yourself, what are my goals? What am I supposed to achieve? How can I achieve this goal? How can I make money today? What can I learn? And you know, when you're in that zone, in that silence, in that privacy, it's priceless. I don't know how to explain it. You know, like people who meditate, when they open their eyes, they are like it's like magic. Same thing with me. The greatest times that I have, the best part of my day is when I make these videos, when I upload it. I'd never consider this work. You know what I consider work? Is when I'm with the client who has paid me money and I'm busy listening to him and analyzing him and giving him solutions. Yes, I respect them. It's not that I consider them shit or anything like that. No. For me, they are more important than my family, than my friends, and because they are giving me money to survive. I've told my wife and I've told her, when a client, customer calls, everything shuts down. Going out, music, disturbance, baby, you, everything. We earn the money, I provide the service, complete the job, now let us enjoy. See, work is worship like this, worship is God. You have to take your work seriously. You have to take your privacy, your silence, your peace of mind, your sleep, your health. First, take care of you. And in order for you to reach that level of whatever you call it, nirvana or whatever, you have to be alone. I find it so exhausting when I talk to people. Really, I get fed up and tired listening to blah, 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 blah. It's not that all of them talk crap, but there are people who I enjoy listening to. For me, my clients, it's a pleasure. Why? Because I'm earning my livelihood. And they have trusted me where... Ooh, coconut fell off. Big one. Caught on camera. You know, when my clients pay me money, it's such an honor. Oh, you trust me, let me give you my best. That's why even if a client pays me and I finish the job and I feel that there's something more I can add, I still call up the client and say, listen, I want to still do something better. They appreciate. So for me, client is the most important. Money comes in. The second one, obviously, my family, because working hard for them, But, when it comes to me, me alone, it comes before my family, it comes even before the client. Why? Because if I'm not at my A game, if I'm not at my best, if I'm not at my peak, the client will not respect me. When I post my videos, people say, oh, what the fuck, man, this and that and whatever. I tell them, you can leave. It's no problem. Because for me, this is my world. And then there are people who like, Loy, I'm supporting your channel by watching your videos. No, you're not supporting me. You're watching because it offers you some value. Tell me, do you spend your time watching hours and hours of bullshit, waste of time, nonsense? No. So, in order to get that value, both for my clients and for the people who are watching, I first need to take care of myself. That is why I tell people, take care of your health. Take care of your brand. Take care of your peace of mind. Take care of your sleep. First is you. So for me, you know, my privacy, my loneliness, the silence, it's very important. And that is exactly why, if you're intelligent, if you're creative, you will choose to be alone. You'll not want all that noise. I can write and give you an open challenge. There's no inventor. There's no person who has discovered something new. There's no person who has learned something who was able to do so by being with so much of noise and people and, you know, interaction and party, you know. They all, even our Indians who are Asians especially, who are very infamous for studying, they'll lock themselves in the room and sit alone and even no music. Sit and study. In order to achieve greatness, you cannot be with people. You have to be alone. And that is why the people who achieve greatness, the people who are creative, and the people who are intelligent, they like to be alone. Self-reflection, self-awareness, self-realization. This doesn't come when you are surrounded by noise and nonsense and nuisance and rubbish. That's why for me, even though my family's there, I have that room. I close myself in that room. I'm in my world. And that's how I've been able to build my brand. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you guys. You let me know your thoughts. Do you think I'm right? Do you think I'm wrong? In fact, I'm pretty sure those of you who stay in joint family or with your parents or brother, sister or friends or whatever. I'm not telling you break up with them. If you want to break up, you break up. But for me, in order to grow, I had to. And that is why, even though I'm a South Indian, even though I was born in a Catholic family, even though my family is conservative and all that, I'm nothing like them, nothing. I'm the only weird person in the family, the only. Anyway, this is what I wanted to share with you.
Yogi.
What I wanted to share with you guys. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Alright. You guys take care. This is me signing off. Ciao.